I'm going to show you how you can generate beautiful Pinterest pins for each of your Shopify products so that you can sell more of your products on Pinterest. So the site we're going to be using is pingenerator.com. And once you're logged in and signed up, you can go to this little side menu and go to products. So this is the products page where you'll be able to import your e-commerce products into PinGenerator. There's the option to import, connect your Etsy store and connect to Shopify store. So for us, we're going to be connecting a Shopify store. So to connect the store, you need to enter your Shopify store name. And that name is going to be the name that is given to you by Shopify, and it is normally in your default URL. So if your URL given to you was awesome-store.myshopify.com, then the store name for your store is going to be awesome-store. So for my case here, we've got pingeneratordevelopment.shopify.com. So this is my development site. This is going to be the name of my store, Pin Generator Development. So let's copy that. We'll put it in the store name here and click Connect Store. So then it'll do some authenticating. It'll go to my store and it'll say, hey, do you want to install this app? This is what it can see. This app can only see your products and collections. And then we'll install the app. And now that the app is installed, we'll see our shop come up here. So now we can see Pin Generator Development Shopify. And this little green dot means it's activated here next to it. If you ever want to unlink it, you can click the trash can here and it'll delete it. So now you can see that it's connected to our Shopify store and it's got a list of all our Shopify products. So that's great. So now to generate pins for them, all we have to do is set the number of pins we want to generate for each listing and check the box next to it. You can also see all the photos we have here for these products. So now we click generate pins and it'll take us through to the generate page where there will be a bunch of pins generated for us. Now we can shuffle these pins to get various different templates and colors by simply clicking the shuffle button. Or if you'd like to customize your settings yourself, you can select the font colors, the colors for the background that you want to use. You can select the font colors too. I like to use the default font colors because it matches the themes. So for this one here, it's the colored text on a white background. And for here, it's the white text on a colored background. And you can also set your font size if you want to adjust that. Now we can see here that my URL is a bit long here. So let's say I wanted to edit that. I would go to bulk settings. So now this section allows you to edit parts of your pins for all of your pins that you can see. So this is the URL text. So let's set that to pin generator. And that's a little bit neater. And we can see that everything's looking quite good. So we can see that there's a picture here. This lady's picture is a little bit off. We can simply click and drag the image to set it right or resize it. You can move the image around and you can resize by clicking on any of the corners and resize the image however you want. Additionally, if you want to edit a single pin, you can click the pencil icon underneath the pin, and this will allow you to select a different image for that pin and to make whatever other changes that you wish. So we can see here that, okay, let's say we wanted to change the pin description here. You can see that all the details that are pulled in here are straight from your Shopify store. So it's got the product title here, the product description here, and the outbound link of what the pin will go directly to that product on your Shopify store. So let's say we wanted to set a different text. I'm just going to say test description. And this is the original pin URL text that we originally had, but we've overridden it here, remember. So the original text is always here, as you can see, so that if we do want to remove the bulk edited text, it reverts back to our original text. So let's save that, and you can see that it still has the bulk setting, the bulk name that we set here. So once you're set up and you're happy with your pins, and there's a lot of different settings you can use. You can use some image settings, you can randomize your images just to generate new pins if you're happy with the templates. You can set your images to be contained rather than to fill the space. So that's quite a handy tool. You can upload your logo, you can upload your own images and then simply click and drag your images onto the pins that you like. You can hide URL text, so that bottom URL text section, you can hide it if you like. And of course there are the bulk actions. You can set your templates if you want to randomize templates or if you want to set specific templates to the ones you like. Let's say you just wanted to use these two. You can set your templates specifically there. And once you're happy with your pins, so let's randomize them. Let's see. So, and once you're happy with the pins that have been created and with all your edits, you have a few options. You can either download the image here, you can pin directly to Pinterest, so you can select a board here that you want to pin to, and you can pin it directly to Pinterest, or you can schedule that pin to go out later. So you click the schedule pin, it'll take that generated image and it'll add it to your automatic scheduling settings. So when will these pins go out? Simply go over to your scheduled pins section here. And when you click on that, you'll see on the left-hand side here is your pin scheduling settings. And on the right-hand side are the pins that have actually been scheduled. So this is a pipeline scheduler. So it's a first in, first out model. So when you schedule a pin, it'll abide by a few scheduling settings. So here, when you set this up, you'll say, okay, I want to pin 20 pins a day. I want to pin pins between 2 and 4 in the morning and 8 and 11 at night. And my time zone is US Pacific time. So you save the scheduling settings and then it just gives you some information about that. So it says, okay, you'll be posting a pin every 15 minutes in each of your time windows. And then the posting times that you have here, these are the actual times when those pins will go out. So when you click schedule pin, your pin is given one of these times. So you can see the pin that we last scheduled, it's gonna go out at 8:15 on August 1st. So that is this time slot here. And then the next pin that we schedule will go out in this time slot and so on and so forth. And then when it gets to the end, the next pin you schedule will go out the next day at this time. So you can see you've got your scheduled pins here and it says how many pins you've got and when they'll run out. So I recommend pinning between 20 and 30 pins a day for mature accounts. If your account is brand new, I would start slower than that and start by pinning maybe 1 to 10 pins per day and then start ramping that up to 20 to 30 per day over the time span of about a month. If you pin too many pins too quickly, you run the risk of being marked as spam by Pinterest. So bear that in mind and just make sure that you're following all of Pinterest's guidelines in terms of, you know, the spammy behavior. So you have all your pins here and you can edit your pins here too if you want to update the description and the title. You have and the board even. You have the ability to do it from this page or you can delete a pin from here easily. So those are the settings and that is in a nutshell how you generate pins for your Shopify products. Thanks for tuning in. Cheers.